So for today's vlog, it's just going to be a quick one because I'll just be introducing. Merong malukulit na extra.
A few inches later.
I do.
A few moments later. 1 eternity later.
Shh. Quiet. Mommy's vlogging. Huwag maingay. And this is my first vlog. So for today's video, it's just going to be a short one because I'm only be introducing myself, the reason why I'm vlogging, and what can you expect from my channel. So I'm Heaven Peña Florida, 30 years old, originally from San Pedro, Laguna, but currently staying in Makati City. I started working at the age of 16 right after I graduated high school. And then from there, I studied in Adamson University. I took mass communications. And then, fortunately, I got discovered in SM Manila as a part-time model and then nag-extra din ako sa TV. However, it was very difficult for me that time kasi my dad just passed away. And then, no one is supporting us, just me and my mom. And that time, I was still so young, 16 years old lang ako. So, it's up to me, how can we survive? Thankfully, nauso yung call center that time. So, at first, I tried to apply in Convergys. I got hired actually, but the thing was, nung nalaman nila na underage ako, I was just only 17, I was just a high school graduate, they declined me. So, nalaman ko yung secret. Although, bawal to guys, so what I did was, I applied in another call center. I won't tell the company nila which one, kasi baka mamaya magkaroon pa ng issue. But I told them I was already 18, and then I was 3-year college already. That time kasi, hindi pa sila tumatanggap ng undergrad. And thankfully, I got hired because if not, I won't be having any opportunity right now. Kasi very thankful ako from the call center. And hello everyone who's working in the call center kasi doon ako nag-start. And if not from the call center, I wouldn't be here kung nasan ako ngayon. So thank you so much. So when I started working in the call center, and mas naging okay na yung life namin ng mom ko, I was able to support myself. And my mom, naging stable naman. But then again, someone inspired me or someone told me to apply as a flight attendant. She told me na, why not? I'm suitable for the job, may tsura naman ako, and then I think I can cope up with the job. Ayun, I had an idea and I did apply. So to Mommy Evett, I hope you are watching right now. I'm very thankful. She's the one who encouraged me to apply. So thank you so much, Mommy Evett. If not, hindi ko matatry maging flight attendant. Hindi ako makakaisip mag-apply kundi dahil sa'yo. And then I did my research. I was able to apply for 2 companies, PAL and Cebu Pacific. Fortunately, I got hired for both. But the problem was, sa PAL kasi, they were not willing to wait during the training. Compared doon sa Cebu Pacific, wherein mabait yung HR, pinayagan niya ako na from batch 43, inabutan ako ng batch 47 bago ako nakapag-start. So, thank you so much, Cebu Pacific. I became a flight attendant at 19. And then, from there, ayun. It was actually yung first flight ko was first time ko rin sumakay ng aeroplan. So wala kasana ng loob yan. And then I got pregnant. So I went back to the call center industry wherein I became a team manager at the age of 21. From there, I've learned a lot. Dun ako nag-mature. Nag-mature ba talaga? But I've learned a lot. I've met a lot of people, different kinds of friends, yung mabait, may fake, at iba-ibang klase din ng ahente, may mabait, may pasawayan, whatever, from the call center industry, you guys know what I'm talking about. But, I'm very thankful kasi, again, if hindi dahil doon, I wouldn't be here right now, and hindi ko ma-experience yung mga bagay na na-experience ko doon. So, I'm very thankful for that. From there, I was looking forward to find another job kasi, I don't know, I felt bored at that time, parang I want something adventure, and it was my dream to be a tour guide. Oh, so ayan, ang lola mo, mag-apply, tour guide daw. So I did apply as a tour guide. I got hired in MTF, Educational Tours. Hello po sa inyo, mga boss ko. Ayan, so experience ko din naman maging tour guide, and I was so happy kasi I've learned a lot, history, grabe yung training nun, you have to memorize a lot of things, and then I was able to try yung on your right side, on your left side, so It was very exciting and fun at the same way. Of course, if you enjoy history and then if you love talking to people and then if you enjoy tours, technically, if you love to travel, it's the right job for you. So there, experience ko rin yon. And then, because I had two jobs, it was very difficult for me to juggle. Nagkasakit na ako, ayan, I had pneumonia. And then, sabi ko, I don't think I would be rich working lang in a certain industry. Much better siguro kung I try a different one. And so, I changed my job. And guess what? I transferred to real estate. Kung saan ako ay nagbibenta ng mga condo at kung ano-ano. So, I applied to this certain company. Unfortunately, wala akong benta, dai. Ang hirap bumenta, high-end. Wala akong connection, I have nothing. So, ang hirap for the first time. Ito pa yung time na I had personal problems. And then, sumabay pa siya. Tapos, walang-wala na din ako that time. Naghirap na naman ang lola nyo. So, ang ginawa ko, nag-part-time ako, part-time English tutor. Eto na. Lola mo nakapag-apply as a part-time English tutor. Hinire naman ako as a secretary. And then when my boss knew about my background, he hired me as a full-time manager na in his office. And right now, I'm working full-time as an executive assistant for a private company. Since then, I've been working with that company or with that boss for the past 5 years na. And aside from that, I have a sideline job wherein we do visas for foreigners coming in, going out, doing working visas for them. Yan, isa yun sa mga part-time ko, aside from selling condos. I also tried selling insurance policies, ayan, sa Pru Life UK. But hindi ko na tinuloy kasi it's very hard if you cannot focus on that job alone. Since I'm juggling many things at the same time, I have my shop, I have another job, and then another job. Ang daming racket ng lola mo, so medyo mahirap. But then again, ayun, it's very fulfilling kasi I was able to experience many things in life through hardships, but I was able to go through with it. If you guys had noticed, I had my background, ayan yung background ko, attitude of gratitude. Yan din yung tattoo ko. Ayan, meron din akong tattoo dyan, attitude of gratitude, because dapat you have to be thankful for all the blessings that you're receiving. Even though blessings, pero you have to think of it na kahit na nahihirapan ka na, the reason is because God is testing you, and the bigger the obstacle, the bigger your achievement will be. Oh, diba? Imbento ka lang yun. Pero yun talaga yung laging nasa isip ko. Pag mas mahirap, ibig sabihin greater opportunities or greater achievement yung makakamit mo. Anyway, so that's it about me. So, second naman, reason is why I'm vlogging. O, diba, ang ingay ng background ko, may kumakalimbang na aso. Kasi yung baby ko, sobrang kulit, sobrang pasaway. I'll show you my baby. Come to mommy. Here is my baby. Say hello. Hello. Hello po. Hello. I love him so much. Later na, he's gonna play. Hello! Hello! Mamaya, I'll show you guys again later. Ayan. So, what's the reason why I am vlogging? Really, I wanted to inspire people. So, I've been through a lot of obstacles before. I've been through a lot. Hardships, whatever, etc. On a separate vlog, I'll just tell you guys in detail na lang. Yun, yung maalaala mo kayong story ko. So, yung mga friends ko, alam nila yan. Kasi dream ko ma-feature yung life story ko sa maalaala mo kayo. So, alam na nila yung title. Mako pa. May ganon. Since then, gusto ko sana maka-inspire na ibang tao. Hopefully, other people like you guys would be inspired with my story. And then, sana makatulong in a way na I know. And then, I can also share with you guys yung mga experiences ko and how I see things through. So, yun lang. Lagi ko lang motto is attitude of gratitude. So just be thankful with all the blessings that you've been receiving, and you know, just be happy. And iwas nega the secret. If you guys are watching it, yeah, it's a very, very good thing to do or to follow. Because for me, that's how I think. Even before I watched that short clip, pero I've been doing it na unconsciously, and that's how I think I was able to go up with the challenges. So, ayun, that's it. Number three, things that I'll be posting here is mostly about business, lifestyle. I wanted to interview those people who became successful. And then, I also wanted to show you guys yung mga tips and tricks for getting this kind of job. For example, as a tour guide, as a flight attendant, as a call center agent, real estate broker, as insurance broker. So, lahat na lang racket na pwede natin gawin para pagkakitaan. I wanted to share to you guys, especially sa business. And then aside from that, fashion din, since I own a shop which is called Afnic Chic Boutique. I hope you guys can follow and support that. I'll be showing you guys this link below for the Facebook page of my shop, Afnic Chic Boutique. Affordable, unique, and chic. Ayan, promote ko na. So, on another vlog na lang yun, I'll be introducing you guys my shop. We're in... I started last year lang. Although it's COVID time right now, it's really difficult to survive. But then again, kapit lang. Kapit lang tayo mga sis. We can do this. So that's it for my vlog. I hope you guys find it interesting. And I hope you guys tell me your comments below on what I need to adjust or anything that you wanted me to feature here or kung ano yung mga vlogs na gusto nyong makita. Ayan, just let me know. I'll be reading all the comments and I'll be replying soon. So if you like this video, please don't forget to thumbs up, like, share, and follow my page at Heaven Peña Florida. I also have a Facebook and Instagram page. Ayon. So there, thanks so much for watching and I hope you guys enjoyed this first vlog ever and I hope to see you guys soon. Bye!